What's happening, guys? Keith here with another edition of the Impact Report. So, this past week marked the start of the new era for Impact Wrestling, and you guys can check out my review by clicking the link above my head. And let's get into things. So, this week, the Global Wrestling Network has been announced to be added to the Xbox One gaming console. They also noted that they have submitted to Roku and are just waiting to hear back, so hopefully that announcement is soon, as I can finally start streaming on something besides my tablet. So, last week we spoke about the WrestlePro Breaks for Impact event, which is scheduled to take place tonight. It was originally announced that it was going to be streamed live on Impact's Twitch page. However, that was later shot down, and it has been announced by Impact themselves that it will stream next Friday, February 9th, on their Twitch page at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So this past week, we learned that Jeremy Borash is no longer with Impact Wrestling. This is a huge hit to the company and kind of came out of nowhere. Last week, it was said that he was at WWE events just visiting friends, but that did not turn out to be true, as he is now employed by WWE and will report to NXT. Like I said, this is a huge hit to the company, as Borash was a man that wore many hats between his commentary role, backstage role, and he was even doing a lot of work with other promotions in terms of negotiations and things like that. Nordholm, while being interviewed by Newsweek, had this to say. He said, "We wish him all the best. He's a talented guy, and he's been with the company forever. But we have a lot of talented guys. Change is good, and it gives other guys a chance to step up." So Jeremy's plans were to host and produce the live audio wrestling podcast on their Impact's Twitch channel. However, I believe they have scrapped that now, and he was supposed to commentate with Don Callis, as Josh Matthews is supposed to be moving out of the commentary role into a different role. Don Callis said that the departure of Jeremy Borash won't change their long-term plans in terms of announcing. As far as the commentary team goes, there's rumors going around that Don Callis and Kevin Kelly are going to be doing the commentary. I think this would be huge for the company, as they are two of the best announcers in today's business. They are currently commentators for New Japan's English language shows, and they just really work well together. It'll definitely be interesting to, if this is true, to hear them outside of New Japan. But I feel that the current Impact commentary team with Borash and Matthews has kind of become disconnected from the product. I'm sure because of Borash leaving, I don't believe we saw them on screen once this week. I believe he has done all the voiceovers for this past set of tapings. So when there is a new commentator team, we won't see them probably until the pay-per-view or the next set of tapings. But like I said, someone leaves, it is a chance for someone else to step up. Even though Borash was one of the, some people say, the heart and soul of Impact, as he has been with them since the inception in 2002. Also this past week, Nordholm, Callis, and Damore were doing media in Great Britain. They were meeting with promoters and production companies in regard to bringing the company there, as well as meeting with UK-based talents. The UK wrestling scene is and has been a big thing. I know when TNA went there years back, they had great turnouts. So there has been rumors about them doing shows in the UK, and this kind of solidifies it. So during this media meeting, they were pushing this week's episode as just the start of changes, and that for all the talents leaving, it creates new opportunities for new talents coming in, but it'll take time for the new characters to become as beloved as the ones who left, which is absolutely true. This past week, we saw the return of Austin Aries, and we got a teaser video for the debut of Brian Cage. Speaking of this past week's Impact, we saw another rise in viewership. had 319,000 viewers, which is 3% up from last week's 310,000 viewers, and it ranked 136 on cable's top 150, same ranking it had last week. But hey, even moving up a little bit is a positive. They're adding more stuff to their Twitch page. They've always got a lot of stuff going on YouTube. They have the Pluto page. You know, any way to bring eyes on the product is great. And last but not least, there was news this past week that a new faction known as the Desi Hit Squad would be joining Impact Wrestling. The members of this faction include, and I apologize if I pronounce any of these names wrong, we have Rohit Raju, who is formerly known as Hakeem Zayn. We've seen him over the last couple of weeks on Impact. We also have Vikas Kumar, Gursinder Singh, and Bhupinder Singh, which will be led by Gama Singh. This is definitely an interesting way to introduce a faction into your wrestling promotion, as most of the time you just kind of see them form on TV. But we'll see how it plays out on TV. I don't know if this is going to be a thing where we get sort of like a little by little introduction, or they're all just going to show up one night and be there. But what Impact has done in the recent past, as far as factions go, with LAX, OVE, and even American Top Team, they've done good work with them, so I'm excited to see this. If you want more information on each of the men in the Desi Hit Squad, you can go to ImpactWrestling.com. They have a whole article on the faction. That's pretty much all I have for you guys this week, so I will see you next week for my Impact review, along with another episode of the Impact Report. So until then, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.